fungerer jo ikke.
Pokker, altså.
Ja, mann, det mulig at jeg alltid er det?
Hey, did some of you play with this audio? It doesn't work.
Typisk akkurat når jeg skal til disse spillene. Kanskje jeg må trykke på det. Skikkelig problem, altså.
Yeah, okay. Oh, sorry. Yeah, now it works. Okay, welcome to this lecture on problem-solving frameworks. We all have problems. Some problems are serious, others are trivial. Some are global, some are very local, or even individual. This lecture is not about how you deal with your personal problems, but how to deal with problems in a professional business setting. In manufacturing, a problem can be seen as a discrepancy between an ideal state and a current state. If we do not meet the ideal state, we have a problem we should solve and seek to hinder from reoccurring. A key message from this lecture is that we should stop seeing problems as only negative. In fact, we should try to love our problems. But why? Because each problem is an opportunity to learn and improve. There are different ways to deal with problems. Roughly, we can differentiate intuition-based methods from structured methods. At the individual level, in his best-selling book, Thinking Fast and Slow, Nobel laureate Daniel Kahneman differentiates between System 1 and System 2 thinking. Both serve a purpose. System 1 is the brain's automatic and unconscious fast thinking mode. It requires little energy and uses intuition to react automatically to whatever happens around us. System 2 is a controlled and analytical slow thinking mode. It is used to carefully consider choices and make a structured and calculated decision. Problem solving in organizations can follow similar patterns. Many problems are dealt with in an ad hoc, let's see if this works approach. We often tend to jump to conclusions. Sometimes it works, and other times we get to learn the hard way. However, it is generally an inefficient way to deal with recurrent problems in manufacturing, and most importantly, it deprives us opportunities for systematic learning. If we instead approach problems more analytically with a structured problem-solving framework, we will do better. So how can we become more structured in our problem-solving efforts? Well, luckily, there's plenty of advice out there. Many suggested methods prescribe a problem-solving logic or concrete steps to follow. Examples include broad frameworks such as systems engineering, design thinking, plan, do, study, act circle, design of experiments, the DMAIC model, the 8 dimensions model, and concrete techniques like A3, 5 Whys, TRIS, and FMEA. I will only review a few of the most general ones in this lecture and leave others for later or for your own self-study. Based on the work of Walter Schuart, William Edward Stemming popularized the PDSA method. PDSA stands for Plan, Do, Study, Act, which is really about scientific thinking. If we want to solve a problem, we should plan a hypothesis or what might work, then do or experiment, then study the results and see if our hypothesis is kept or rejected. And finally, we need to act according to our new knowledge. You may come across PDSA as PDCA, where study is replaced with check. This is a Japanese version based on the DMAIC seminar series in Japan in the 1950s. Practically, doesn't really matter. In his work on Kaizen, Masaki Imai extended the PDCA model into a 7-step problem-solving method, including defining the problem, then analyzing the problem, identifying the causes for the problem, for example by asking why 5 times or using fishbone diagrams, planning countermeasures, implementation of these measures, then confirmation of results, and if positive, standardize the new process. Deming did not stop with one method. He also suggested a more refined model called DMAIC in the 1950s. This 5-step method was later adopted by Motorola and became one of the key roadmaps in the popular Six Sigma improvement philosophy. DMAIC stands for Define, Measure, Analyze, Improve, and Control. What sets it apart from the more general PDSA cycle is the explicit focus on measurement. DMAIC is a data-driven, customer-focused, structured problem-solving framework. But of course there's more. Many other problem-solving methods are developed and in use. For example, One is called the 8 disciplines and was developed by Ford. Its objective is to identify root causes using statistical methods, correct them, and then eliminate recurring problems by implementing permanent corrective actions. The 8 disciplines are: build a team, define the problem, implement a containment action, which means doing a quick fix before engaging in a more analytical problem solving, then determine the root cause, verify the root cause, implement a corrective action, ensure prevention, and congratulate the team. Did you notice how similar all these methods are? All are variants of the classic scientific method, and each gives practical advice on what sequence to follow. The important thing is not what you call your framework, but how you go about solving problems. If we learn to see problems as opportunities to learn and improve, we are likely to do a better job solving them and hindering them from reoccurring. In this perspective, there is something to Taichi Ono's words. Having no problem is the biggest problem of all. Using a structured problem-solving framework, at the very least as a thinking frame, will help us solve problems more effectively and sustainably. So, what's the problem?